The Hazardous Waste Incineration Process. Hazardous waste from local industries, both solid and liquid, undergoes compliance checks before being categorised and injected into the incinerator. The composition of waste mixtures requires advanced expertise. It is continuously adjusted by experts to ensure atmospheric emissions comply with regulatory thresholds. Combustion takes place in two stages. The waste is fed into a rotary kiln heated to very high temperatures, which gasifies contaminants and initiates the breakdown of molecules. Then solid residues, called bottom ash, are removed and stored in secure sites. In some countries, valuable metals are extracted from this material. In the post-combustion chamber, gases are heated to 1100 degrees Celsius and maintained at this temperature for at least 2 seconds while additional liquid waste is injected. This high temperature treatment ensures the complete decomposition of toxic molecules. As regards to PFAS, tests in Veolia's facilities have shown 99.9999% destruction of the regulated compounds. Thermal energy from combustion is recovered to produce heat and electricity. To do so, the heat from the flue gas is captured in a boiler to generate steam, which is converted into electricity, making the facility energy self-sufficient. The recovered heat can be used to supply a district heating network or a nearby industrial site. The flue gases are then cooled through a tower using recycled industrial water. Customized reagent mixtures are injected to neutralize various contaminants, including acid compounds, heavy metals, and other toxic substances. A bag filter system then captures all remaining dust and ash particles. Advanced smart monitoring systems continuously analyze stack emissions through gas sensors, ensuring pollutant levels remain significantly below regulatory thresholds. This comprehensive approach enables to maximize the recovery and preservation of resources, control atmospheric emissions, and thus protect the environment and the quality of life of local residents.